Good morning, Namini Nimita, Nirmita, Rufia, Tejaswini, Shravani, Disha A, Huseifa, Deepika. Voice audio is clear, right? Okay. So I started little 5 minutes early today, so we'll just wait for some time. In the meantime, those who are present, think about the simple questions which we have covered already. First question, second question, third question. The diagrams should be able to tell you what I'm asking. Okay, so try once, all of you. Good morning, Lavanya. Usually I say Lavanya, okay. There was a student last year, so I used to call her Lavanya like that. She used to say, sir, you are making my name very English like that, okay. Pratibha, good morning. Zainab. Good morning, Tejaswini from New Oxford, Saida, Amina, good morning, Hafsa, good morning, Mithun. So try to answer these questions. Rakshita, good morning. Good morning, Tanuj, Punima, Ravi Kumar, good morning. Prakriti, remind me during the little end time, okay, end time. Because right now many have not come. Chetana, good morning. Good morning, Sanjana. Good morning, Ankita. Achha, tell me one thing. Right now, when you are looking at the video classes and all, are you able to chat with each other? Can you chat with each other? Like, can one of you send message to another one privately like that? Some are saying yes, sir. Some are saying no, sir. No, I'm not asking whether you are doing or not. Obviously, you will not say you are doing. But is it possible to do or not? I'm asking. Is it possible? We can't. Okay, can't do Kirti. Okay, it is not possible. Okay, good, good. Otherwise, no. What will happen is I will be teaching here, and you will be chatting about something. Okay, okay. Thank you. Good, good. So good thing they have done. Okay, okay. Nice, nice. I think Rakshita had answered one of the question. Okay. So I think we'll start the class. So look here, all of you concentrate now. Okay, I understood. Thank you so much. So we'll start. Okay. So just small revision we will do once, just to check everybody. We are all on the same page. Okay, all of us are understanding basics. Okay. So look here. If you have n capacitors, identical capacitors, identical matlab what? Area will be same, distance will be same, and medium will be same. So if area is same, distance is same between the plates, then obviously capacitance will be same, because capacitance formula is what? Epsilon naught A by D. Right? So if you have n identical capacitors in series, then what will be the total capacitance? Quickly tell me without wasting time. So many have already answered, or so many, matlab three of them have answered. Very good. So why it is C by N is because in series, what formula we use? 1 by CS is equal to 1 by C plus 1 by C plus 1 by C, like that. You have to keep writing N times. So that will give you total as NC. NC, right? Because N of them are there. Yes or no? A plus A plus A plus A plus A, N times will be NA. So 1 by total capacitance will be N by C. Ulta you have to do, ulta. So total capacitance will be C by N. So try to remember these basics answers. So if you have N identical capacitors in series, total capacitance will be C by N. You can see total will be less than this one. For example, if this is 10 and I use 5 capacitors, if this is 10 microfarad and I use 5 capacitors, it will be 10 by 5. How much? 2 microfarad. So in series, when you connect, capacitance will decrease. Here you see what will happen. Here what will be the answer? I think it is simple, NC. Because in parallel, we simply add. Correct, na? Okay. Now, for is now, okay, understood. Concentrate now. Suppose you have a single capacitor which, and I apply voltage V. Voltage, then you know this standard formula, V equals to Q by C, or sometimes I write Q equal to CV. Now, what is this meaning of V? Quickly tell me, what is the meaning of this V in this formula? Not in the previous chapter. In the previous chapter, V means potential at a point. But in this formula, what is V? What is V? Very good. Very good. V is not potential. Okay. V is potential difference between the plates. Be very careful. So V is potential difference between the plates. So if I say one plate is plus 100 volt, other plate is plus 20 volt, then what number will you write here? 80 volt. Why 80 you will write? Because this V means potential difference between the positive plate and the negative plate. Okay. See, negative actually means low potential. That's it. In battery, when people say this is the battery, right? They will say this is plus, this is minus, right? What does this longer line represent? Higher potential. This shorter line represents lower potential. Because what is important is potential difference only. When you buy a battery, you will be asking what is the potential difference. Understood? No, so difference is important. What is the exact potential? That is not important. If somebody says potential difference of this battery is 100 volt, then you can say this is 100, this is 0. Understood? Or you can say this is 120, this is 20. It doesn't matter. Potential of one point doesn't matter. What matters is potential difference. Okay, so these basic things I wanted to revise. What question we have to do today? which question we have to start. Question number 8 we have to start, right? Okay. So before I start the question, some announcement I will make. Okay. I have today evening after this class, I will be posting assignment 2 for NEET level and JE level. JE level, few questions are there. Mostly it is for NEET level. And you even JE students can see, obviously, because if the basics are not correct, how will they do difficult questions? Yes or no? So I have posted some 42 questions. Solutions will be also there this time. Last time I did not give solution. This time you will get two files. One file will have questions with keys, answer keys. Another file will have solution, detailed solution. But my advice is don't see the solution directly. First, you try to solve the question as much as you can. Spend 20 minutes also in one question, no problem. But when you search for the answer, you will learn many things. That is what I want from all of you. That is how I used to study. Search answer of one question nicely. Okay, if you know it easily, then no problem. If you don't know, then keep searching for it. Directly don't see solution, directly don't ask somebody. Try to read books, try to see my videos, try to see the notes, and try to solve it by yourself. That will make you grow as a student and as a person who wants to study more in physics. Okay, students? So keep that in mind. Solution is given, but directly don't see the solution. And by at least next PTE, you try to cover it because these questions will be important for next PTE. So we will do question number 8 now. Now let us do, before I do question number 8, before I start question number 8, let us remember one problem which we did yesterday. So if you have a capacitor which is charged, okay, and suppose I put here dielectric medium, which has dielectric constant K. Then if you remember, electric field here, if it is E, here also E, here how much was the electric field? Here electric field was how much in terms of E, if I write? E, if I say this is E naught, then this was E naught by K. So this is how we write in series, you know, electric field inside will be less than outside. So in dielectric medium, electric field will be less. Yesterday we did one last problem, right? Today we have similar question, but it is very different, unique question it is. So try to see carefully. And today is the last day for this chapter. Remaining MCQs, whichever is left, I will be posting separate video. And Thursday 9 o'clock, it will be put in the group. Sorry, not group, in the EduShrine channel. Thursday 9 o'clock, remaining questions, including JE. I hope NEET questions we will be able to cover today. But if some questions are pending, because some of you may ask me to repeat. So if any questions are pending, I will be making a separate video and posting it on Thursday 9 a.m. on our EduShrine channel. Please see. And from tomorrow, we will start next chapter. Okay. So question number 8 says, A parallel plate capacitor is charged from a cell and then isolated from it. Like this. So it has been charged. A dielectric slab of dielectric constant K is now introduced in the region between the plates. Here they have put dielectric medium. And dielectric constant is K. Filling half of it, the electric field intensity, electric field in the dielectric is E1, they are saying. Here electric field is E1. Here it is E2. What is the relation they are asking? Now listen carefully. Most of the students will do like this. They will remember whatever I told here. Correct, na? So they will think, oh, outside it is E2. Inside it will be E2 by K. No, outside divided by K. So this will be the electric field in the medium. So this will be the relation they will think. Okay, and if you think this is the answer, which will be the correct option? Option D. But students, it is completely wrong. Now you have to think why it is like that. Listen carefully. If you look this upper part and this lower part, okay, let me think this upper part as one capacitor and lower part as one capacitor. Only difference is in the lower part there is a dielectric, and you can see this is same plate connected to each other. This is same plate connected to each other. In what combination are this upper part and lower part? What combination? Parallel combination. Prabha has already mentioned. Amina is mentioning. It is in series. Yes, Ashwini, these two are in parallel. No, this and this. Right. So since it is in parallel, you know that potential difference. See, this is one conductor. So if these points have potential 100 volt, all the points will be 100 volt. Similarly, if I say this point is 10 volt here, every point will be 10 volt. So the difference here and here will be same. So potential difference here and here must be same. It has to be same. In the previous case, it was in series. So that was not necessary. But in parallel, potential difference has to be same. Now, distance is also same. D is same. Correct or not? Distance is also same. So what happens is, what is the formula for potential difference? Electric field into D. In previous chapter also I have taught. So you can see, this is same. This is also same. So it means E also has to be same. So please don't think this is the answer. I will explain this part also, don't worry. But right now try to understand, this upper part and lower part are in parallel. Whether battery is connected or not, I know the potential difference will change. When you remove the battery and when you put the dielectric, potential difference compared to before will change, I know that. But even if it changes, whatever change happened here, same change will happen here also, because it is in parallel. So potential difference here and here must be same. Understood? It may not be same as the previous one because battery is removed. But whatever is the potential difference here must be same as here, because these two are in parallel. If potential difference is same, distance is same, electric field also must be same. In other words, E1 must be equal to E2. Now you will think, but sir, what about this dielectric? So first part, see, this part we have answered. Very good. Okay, now, but sir, what about this dielectric here? If there is dielectric here, usually electric field will decrease, no sir? Huh, it will. It will try to decrease, but since they are in parallel, since this upper plate and lower plate are connected to each other, what will happen is charge will flow. Charge will flow like this, because capacity of this will increase. Capacitance of this will increase. So charge will flow till the potential difference will become same. Charge will flow from upper plate to lower plate. So initially, when there was no dielectric, let us say this was having 2 coulomb minus 2 coulomb. That means this had 2 coulomb like this, and this has minus 2 coulomb like this. Okay, initially. The moment you put dielectric here, what will happen? Some charges will come this side. So the charge here will be more than here. Understood or not? So some charges will come this side. So total charge is still 2 coulomb, but before it was 1 coulomb, 1 coulomb. Now it may be 0.5 coulomb, 1.5 coulomb like that. So that is how the potential difference is same, because of the flow of charge. Okay, students. Now let me add one extra question. Write this first. First you understand. Since potential difference is same, distance is same, electric field here and here has to be same. There is no other way because of this relation. Okay. Once you accept this fact, then they may add another extra question. They may say, here the surface charge density is sigma 1. Here it is sigma 2. Surface charge density. What is the relation between these two, they may ask. Before it was same.
when this dielectric was not there, here and here, charge will spread uniformly. But the moment you put dielectric in the lower part,
I told you potential difference has to be same. How it will be same?
Right, flow of charge. So charge will flow from here to here, from upper part to lower part.
And it will flow till
potential difference here and here will be same. So they may ask relation between charge density here and charge density here. How will we find the relation? Very simple. So here, what will be your electric field? This is E2. So E2 will be sigma 1 by epsilon naught.
Yes or no? This formula we know already.
And here it will be, because there is K, it will be reduced. Sigma 2 by K epsilon naught.
K, because it is dielectric is there. Chetan, how can you ask suddenly in the middle when I'm discussing? Who is this Chetan Chetu? Which college you are from? Okay, anyways, I'll discuss with you later.
So charge will flow till potential difference here and here will be same, students, right? Now, what is the electric field here? E2, they have told. What will be E2 in terms of surface charge density?
Sigma by epsilon naught.
Here what it will be? Sigma by K epsilon naught, because there is dielectric. Now, we know just now I told electric field has to be same.
Electric field has to be same because potential difference is same. So if electric field is same,
you can substitute these two here. Sigma 1 by epsilon naught, sigma 2 by K epsilon naught. So you will get sigma 1 equal to sigma 2 by K. So this will be the relation between
surface charge density in the upper part and in the lower part. Okay. Can you tell me what would be the surface charge density relation if this was not there?
If this dielectric was not there, then what will be the relation between these two?
Sigma 1 and sigma 2. Quickly tell me.
If this dielectric was not there,
then what will be there? If dielectric is not there, it will be equal. It will be equal. Very good. Very good. Very good. Why it will be equal? Because if there was no dielectric medium, then what will be there? Air will be there. If air is there, what is the dielectric constant of air? 1. So in that case, it will be equal. Okay.
So write this very interesting question we have done today.
And many students think the option B is the right answer. But you have to be careful that the upper part and lower part are in parallel. Make a note quickly. Is it done? No. If electric field is same, it doesn't mean distribution of charge should be same
because dielectric is there. Since there is dielectric here, you cannot expect surface charge density here and here will be same because dielectric is there. So this K will come.
Okay, this K is there. Okay, so if this K was not there, of course, then you know sigma 1 and sigma 2 has to be same. But because there is K, you know that compared to previous one, it will decrease by K times. Okay.
Done, right, students? Okay. So try to understand this concept. So compared to the previous electric field, when dielectric was not there, compared to previous one,
yes, it has decreased, no doubt. So no, sir, when dielectric is not there, Tanuj, correct. When no dielectric is there, then distribution will be same. Super. Let us see the next question now. Question number 9. A series combination of N1 capacitors, each of value C1, is charged by a source of potential difference 4V. So that you keep in mind.
So there is a series N1 capacitors. Each of them is C1, 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 C1. N1 capacitors, and it has been charged by what voltage? 4V. Okay. When another parallel combination of N2 capacitors in parallel. In parallel is charged by what voltage? Each of value C2. This is C2. Charged by a source of potential difference V, only V. Has the same energy stored, total energy stored in both the cases are same, they are same. Then what will be C2 in terms of C1 they are asking. So they are saying N1 capacitors are in series and they have been given 4V voltage. Similarly, N2 capacitors are in parallel, each value C2 and voltage given is V. Energy stored here and here are equal. What will be the relation between C2 and C1 they are asking. Simple question, look here. What will be energy stored here? Half. What is the total capacitance in series? C1 by N1, right? Because it is in series, so 1 by C1 plus 1 by C1, N times you have to do. So it will be N by C1. Ulta will be C by N. So C here is C1. Number of capacitors is N1. So half total capacitance, voltage is 4V. 4V squared. So this is the energy stored in the first case. They told energy stored in the first case is same as in the second case. In the second case, what will be the energy stored? Half total capacitance. C2 parallel will be N into C. But here number of capacitance is N2. Capacitance is C2. Voltage applied is V squared. Then this you have to solve. Very easy question. So you can see, you can cancel half. Half and half can be cancelled. V square can be cancelled. So it will be 16 C1 by N1 equals to N2 C2. Correct, na? So they wanted C2 in terms of C1, right? Yes, C2 in terms of C1. So bring N2 this side. So C2 will be 16 C1 by N1 N. So in exam, try to do this way, students. It will be faster. Okay, don't try to write separately total capacitance of this is how much. Separately total capacitance of this is how much. Separately better, no need. Because this is not board exam. Okay, this is for entrance. So find the total capacitance in series. It will be C by N. Then into voltage. Square, that is the formula for energy stored, half CV square. Okay, and when you are given many capacitors, you should use total capacitors. Total capacitors. Okay, done. Tomorrow we will be starting current electricity chapter. Okay, students. So it is the first day, first topic will be taught. So try to not miss the class.
Now let us see question number 10. Two condensers. Condensers are old word for capacitors. So condensers, if they say, it is capacitors only. Two capacitors, one of capacity C and the other of capacity C by 2 are connected to a V volt battery as shown. The work done in charging fully both the condenser. Work done in charging means what? Whatever energy is stored. Whatever energy is stored in the capacitors, that will be work done by the battery to store the charge. Otherwise, you know, work done by battery is twice of that.
So here one battery is there, V volt. Here one capacitor is there. Here one capacitor is there. What is the capacitance here? C. Here C by 2.
Okay, initially these capacitors were uncharged. So before there was no energy stored.
Once you connect to this battery, you know they are in parallel. So both will get same voltage. So energy stored will be, here how much energy will be stored? Half C V square plus, here how much energy will be stored? Half C, C is C by 2, V is same. Why V is same? In parallel. So that will be, if I take 1 by 2 C V square common into 1 plus half, that will be 3 by 2. So 3 by 4 C V square. That is the answer.
So that will be the energy stored in both the capacitor together. So that must be the work done by the battery to charge the capacitor.
Another way you can do, you can write half total capacitance into V square.
That also we can do. This is what we did previous question.
So if you apply this formula, what will you get? These two are in parallel, right? This plate and this plate are joined directly. So in parallel, what is the formula? C1 plus C2. So this will give you 3 by 2 C. So it will be 3 by 4 CV square.
So whichever formula you want to apply, if you want to do individually and add, that is your wish, or you can find total capacitance and then find the energy stored. Whichever method you find easy, you can apply. That will be the work done to charge the capacitor. Done? Yeah, Nishchita, if anything is there, you can tell me. Okay.
Work done by battery, if they ask, it will be twice of this.
Because you know half of the energy will be lost as heat.
Question number 11, you see.
If the area of each plate is A and the successive separations are D, 2D and 3D, then what will be the equivalent capacitance between A and B, they are asking.
So one plate is here, one plate is here, one plate is here, one plate is here. This distance is D, this is 2D and this is 3D. These two are joined directly.
Let me use another color.
These two are joined directly.
And they are asking potential difference between
A and B. So this is A and this is B. Like this question we have done before also.
But before, if you remember, the distance was same. But now I've increased the distance. Okay. So how to solve this problem? First thing to do is what I told.
First you number the plate. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Everybody try to answer this question. Will these two form capacitor? Will 2 and 3 form capacitor? No, it will not form because they are joined to each other. If you join to each other, then how it will form capacitor? To form capacitor, there should be potential difference.
So let us rearrange. So plate number 1 will form capacitor with plate number 2. Okay. Plate number 2 and 3 will not form. Plate number 3 is connected to plate number 2. Connected. And plate number 3 will form capacitor with plate number 4. And they want total capacitance between this plate. Plate number 1, this is terminal A and this is terminal B. See, so simple question.
Correct now.
Now, what is the capacitance of this? Epsilon naught A by D. What will be, let us write, this is C1. So, what will be this capacitance? C2. It will not be same now. Be careful because distance is different. So, between 3 and 4, it is 3D. So, it will be, if I write this as C and this as C dash, then what will be capacitance? Epsilon naught A by distance is 3D. Right, students?
And these two are in what combination? Series combination.
So in series combination, 1 by total will be 1 by C plus 1 by C dash.
Okay, substitute here and try to solve.
So this will be D by 3 epsilon naught, D by epsilon naught A plus 3d by epsilon naught a. Ulta it will become now 1 by c it is. So this will become 4d by epsilon naught a, 1 by total capacitance.
Okay. So what will be total capacitance? Reciprocal you do, ulta, ulta. So it will become epsilon naught a by 4d. You can write this as c by 3 also. This is c. So this will be c by 3. That way also you can solve, whichever way you want. So be careful. In this question, the distance between the plates are not same. So the right answer is option B. Option B. Okay. So please remember, 2 and 3 will not form capacitor because they are joined directly. Done. Okay. Let me run this also. See question number 12. Three capacitors, listen carefully, okay? Three capacitors, each of capacitance C and breakdown voltage capital V. Now let us remember, breakdown voltage means if you apply that much voltage, if you apply more than that much voltage actually, if you apply more than that voltage, the electric field will be so high that the dielectric will break down. Break down matlab what? Dielectric will start conducting. If you remember, some of you used to say corona discharge like that. So the dielectric will start getting ionized and therefore it will no longer hold the charge. So the charge will just flow from one plate to another plate. Meaning, you should never apply a voltage greater than breakdown voltage. So breakdown voltage means, write down somewhere, breakdown voltage is the maximum voltage up to which the capacitor can be charged. Breakdown voltage is the maximum voltage up to which capacitor can be charged. More than that, if you apply, the capacitor will simply leak. The charge will simply leak. So there are three capacitors. Each of them has breakdown voltage capital V and they are joined in series.
Capacitance for each of them is CCC. Question is, the capacitance and breakdown voltage of the combination they are asking. For combination, for this combination, what will be breakdown voltage? Now, if you want the maximum voltage here, breakdown voltage means maximum. More than that, you should not apply ma. Understanding? Okay. So here you want maximum voltage. If you want maximum here, you should have maximum here, maximum here, maximum here. And maximum here is voltage is V, here is also V, here is also V. So the maximum voltage for the combination, they are asking for combination. But it will be how much? V1 plus V2 plus V3. But the V plus V plus V, that will be 3V.
Correct na?
And what will be capacitance, total capacitance? It is in series. So 1 by C plus 1 by C plus 1 by C. 3 by C, ulta, C by 3. So that is the answer. So total voltage that you can apply, maximum, this is maximum, is 3V and total capacitance is C by 3. And since it is in series, charge has to be same everywhere. So charge here will be C into V, charge here will be C into V, charge here will be C into V.
Okay, fine. So please remember this simple question. Okay,
let us see the next question now. Next question is
a sister of this question, but little complicated.
Same question, but solpa twisted. Okay,
it is slightly twisted. So look carefully what they are saying. Listen carefully. a capacitor of capacitance 1 microfarad can withstand a maximum voltage of 6 kilovolt. So that is the breakdown voltage, maximum voltage. Okay, 6 kilovolt. And another capacitor of capacitance 2 microfarad can withstand a maximum voltage of 4 kilovolt. So this time the maximum voltage for the two capacitors are not same. Before it was VEV. So answer was simple, 2V. But now you have to be careful. One capacitor has 6 kilovolt, other capacitor has 4 kilovolt maximum voltage. If they are connected in series, what is the maximum voltage that the combination can withstand? The maximum voltage for the combination. Some of you may be thinking, simple sir, add V1 and V2. Be careful. Be careful. Look here.
Two capacitors are in series. Maximum voltage here for the first one. For the first one. Let me write 1 here. Maximum is how much? 6 kilovolt. Maximum voltage for the second one is how much? Where is it? Yeah, 4 kilovolt. Capacitance of this is 1 microfarad. Capacitance of this is 2 microfarad.
Okay, now listen carefully.
They are asking how much maximum voltage you can apply here. Maximum voltage for combination. How much can you apply?
Some of you may be thinking, is the video getting stuck, students? Is the video getting stuck? No, sir. Okay, Neelavati, just keep waiting. Maybe it will get proper, okay?
Now, they want maximum voltage here.
Okay, some of you are thinking,
sir, simple. Here maximum is 6. Here maximum is 4.
Correct, na?
Here maximum is 6. Here maximum is 4. So, total will be 10 only. No, sir. Be careful. If I say this is 6 and this is 4, what will be the charge here? Charge here. C into V. So, it will be 6 into 1. 6. Whatever units, I don't care.
Forget about the units.
So, charge here will be 6 into 1. What will be charge here? 4 into 2. This is 6 into 1. Array,
charges are different. But you know in series charge has to be? In series charge has to be? Same. In series charge has to be same.
So, you cannot assume this maximum voltage is here and this maximum voltage is here. You cannot assume like that. So, be careful. So, let us assume voltage here is V1, voltage here is V2. Now, you know that in series, this voltage I am not saying is the maximum. Okay, I am just writing some voltage is here V1, some voltage is here V2. When you apply voltage here, some voltage will be here, some voltage will be here.
Correct, na?
Okay. What will be charge here? Q1 must be same as charge here. What will be charge here? C1 into V1, charge here. C2 into V2. What is C1? 1. What is C2? 2. That means V1 is twice of V2. So this always has to be true.
Understood?
Okay. So now if you want maximum here, you have two options. Either put maximum voltage here, 4, or put maximum voltage here, 6. If you put maximum here, 6, if this is 6, then what will be V2? If this is 6, what will be V2? If this is 6, what will be this?
3.
And if V2 is 3 volt, will this break down? Will this break down? If this is 3 volt, will this break down? No, it will not break down. Why it will not break down? Because maximum is 4. So if you put maximum for V1, then V2 will be 3 volt and it will not break down. But suppose you put maximum for V2. What is maximum for V2? 4. If this is 4, what will be this? Let me
take another color.
if you take maximum for this, what will be maximum of this? Because this relation has to be obeyed all the time. This relation has to be obeyed all the time because they are in series. You cannot run away from this formula. This has to be true because these two are in series. So if you put maximum here, what will you get here? 8. If this is 8, will this break down or not? Yes, it will break down because 8 means more than 6.
Understood, students? Therefore, students, you cannot put maximum here.
You have to put maximum here. That means the red one will be the answer. So this is the voltages that should come. So here you should be, here you will get 6 volt. Here you will get 3 volt. So what will be the answer now? Maximum to the combination will be how much? So this red one we have to choose. Why red one we have to choose? If you choose the black one, then this will break down.
But you don't want any capacitor to break down. Correct? Na? They are asking maximum up to which you can charge.
So if this is 6, this will be 3. So total will be how much? Total will be 6 plus 3, 9 volt. So answer is 9 volt. So I hope everybody understood very nicely. I think I have explained. So please try to concentrate in this problem. And let us say there are three capacitors. I will give you one homework also. I will give you one homework also. You try. So please remember, you cannot simply say this is 6, this is 4 like that. If you say this is 6, this is 4, answer will be 10. 10 may be there in the option, but it will be wrong. Why it will be wrong? Because if this is 6 and this is 4, then charge cannot be same. Right? You know that charge has to be same. So first what you should find? First you should find relation between voltage here and voltage here. This is the relation. Now they told maximum they want, maximum. So two options. Either you put maximum here and check how much will you get here, or put maximum here and check how much will you get here. That is what I did. So when I put maximum for this capacitor, 4, you see you are getting 8, which will break down this capacitor.
So that we don't want.
But if you put maximum here, 6, then you will get here 3. And 3 means it is less than maximum,
so it will not break down. So this is the answer we have to choose.
Okay, shall I rub it?
I hope everybody understood. Okay. Let me give you one homework question.
Three capacitors, 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad, 3 microfarad. Maximum for this is 100 volt, maximum for this is 50 volt, maximum for this is 80, or let me like, okay, let me make it simple, no? Fine, 150 volt.
So your job is to find what will be the maximum voltage for the combination. Okay, so try this. Again, be careful, charge has to be same everywhere. So write the question before sleeping, try once.
Some of you are trying now only. Don't try now. Now you have to concentrate on the next question. So write the question and keep it safely. Done? So maximum here 100, maximum here 50, maximum here 150. Okay.
Let us see the next question now. Question number 14, you see.
Before we do 40, actually let us do 40, no problem.
See what they are saying. A circuit has a section AB as shown in the figure. So there is a circuit. They have not shown the whole circuit, only one small part.
There is a capacitor, there is a battery, and there is a capacitor. Okay. The EMF of the cell. For the battery, the potential difference is 10 volt. Capacitor here is 1 microfarad. Capacitance here is 2 microfarad. And this potential difference here between A and B, between A and B potential difference, they are given 5 volt.
Find the charge on the capacitor. Since it is in series, you can see there is no junction. If I go from here to here, there is no junction. No junction means they are in series.
So same charge will be stored. So let us assume charge is coming like this. So this is Q minus Q, Q minus Q.
Okay. So now how to solve this problem? Very simple. Tell me what is the potential difference here?
This is plus plate, minus plate. Because I wrote plus Q minus Q. So potential difference here will be what? Let me write V1. That will be Q by C1. Potential difference here is 10. Potential difference here is how much? Q by C2. Correct now? So potential difference here is Q by C1. Potential difference here is Q by C2. Now total potential difference from here to here is 5.
Now some of you may be thinking
this V should be V1 plus V2 plus V3.
That formula you remember, no? Total voltage is V1 plus V2 plus V3. But be careful.
When I go from here to here, I am going from higher potential to lower potential. Higher potential to lower potential. So potential difference for first capacitor, when I go from here to here, is Q by C1. And I am going from higher to lower. Potential difference for this battery is, look here, you are going from minus to plus. This is minus. So if you take from here to here positive, from here to here you have to take negative.
Understanding or not? Why like that? Because here potential is dropping, here potential is rising. So you cannot add rise and drop. You have to subtract rise with drop or drop with rise. One of them you have to take positive, that is your wish.
Similarly, potential difference for this C2 will be how much? Plus to minus. So it will be Q by C2.
So you cannot simply add this potential difference as this plus this plus this. The reason is this is ulta. Ulta. Ulta matlab it is not plus minus. It is minus plus. So total potential difference 5 total will be potential difference here Q by C1. Potential difference here, but you write minus 10. Don't write Q by C for this. This is battery. Why you are writing Q by C?
And for this, it will be plus Q by C.
Understanding? So this is how you should write the equation. You cannot write plus here again and again, I am telling you. Because usually how do we write?
This V will be V1 plus V2 plus V3.
I know. Usually we write like that.
But this is ulta, no? Ulta.
Ulta matlab, this is plus minus, this is plus minus, but this is minus plus. So you cannot do like that.
So let us put the values. C1 is 1 microfarad, so 10 power minus 6. Q2, C2 is 2 microfarad, so 2 into 10 power minus 6.
Now you solve this.
If you solve this, what will you get?
This will come this side. So it will be 15 equals to Q common, 10 power minus 6 common, 1 plus half is 3 by 2. Cross multiply. So Q will be 15 into 2 by 3 into 10 power minus 6. So it will be 10 into 10 power minus 6 coulomb. Okay. So be very careful with this part. What will you do, students, if this battery was given like this? If it was given like this, then what will you do? What sign will you write here? Because this is also drop, this is also drop, this is also drop. Plus, but be careful. If the battery was like this, no, this voltage will be given more. This voltage will be given more. It will be given like 30 volt or 40 volt like that.
How can this be 5? If this is 10,
this cannot be 5, right? If it is 5 also, if you solve, you will get negative charge. You will get negative charge, which means charge is not coming this way. Charge is coming this way. Okay, so try to do that part also.
whenever you solve one question, try to think what will happen if you do some small changes.
Don't do very big change. If you do big change, then the problem only will change. No, small changes you do and try to think. So this completes the neat part. Let me
give you one classwork to try here.
I will give you approximately 2 minutes, because in neat exam also you get 2 minutes only for one question.
So look here. This has capacitance C. This has capacitance C. This point is A. This point is B. This point is C. Or let me write P, Q, R. Otherwise, no, this C will confuse with this C. Now, potential at P is, let's say, 10 volt.
Potential, not potential difference. Potential.
Potential here is 10 volt. Potential here is, okay, let me write C1, C2. 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad. If it is equal, then you try 1 like that. And potential here is, let's say, 2 volt.
Potential again.
Question is, find potential of this point. Chalo, try everyone.
So let me mention here,
these are potential at P and Q. I1 potential at R.
Try. Hint is required. Hint. You want any hint? Anyone wants hint? You tell me, I will give you a small hint. You people are in the class or not? Okay. So hint is this. Ankita, look here. Hint is Rakshita, look here. Okay. Now enough. I understood. I'll give the hint now. Look here.
These two are in series. So charge here and charge here should be same.
First hint.
And whenever you write Q equal to C V,
V is potential difference. V is what? Potential difference.
Difference further, this potential minus this potential.
Okay. So that is the hint. Tejas has done very good. I have to check the answer, Tejas.
So remember, if I assume charge here is Q, this will be minus Q and this will be also Q because it is series.
Correct, na? Okay. Others also try. Rufia also got very good.
So look here, how to solve this problem? Charge on the first capacitor should be equal to charge on the second capacitor because it is in series. What will be charge on the first capacitor? C1 into V1. And here C2 into V2.
Those who came on time, they know this V is potential difference across the plates. Potential difference between the plates.
So C1 is 1 microfarad. V1 is potential difference here. Correct, na? It is potential difference.
How many times I will say, my throat is paining, ma? In the formula of capacitor, whenever you write Q equal to CV, V is potential difference.
So this potential difference is how much? This is 10. This is 10. This we don't know. So it will be 10 minus VR. C2 is 2 microfarad. What is potential difference here? Potential here minus potential here. So VR minus potential here. Potential here, how much I get? 2. Then you can easily solve. So 10 minus VR will be 2 into VR minus 4. Bring minus 4 this side. 14 equals to 3 VR. Oh, very good. Most of you got the right answer. VR will be 14 by 3.
So it's a very different kind of question, but it is also simple, right? Only thing you should know is, yes, Rakshita, correct. So only thing you should know is what students, you should know whenever I write V for capacitor, V for capacitor, it means potential difference. Actually, we should write delta V, but Om Baba, no, he started writing V in Ohm's law for potential difference. So from for that case, it is bad. For capacitor also, we write V only. Okay, write fast.
Now we will do some JEE questions in whatever time is there,
and NEET people, don't run away. These questions will help you to understand more, so you will be able to do, you will be able to do more better.
So NEET people should not run away, because the first question is important for board exam also. So JEE first question, it is important for board exam also.
Okay, so what is the question? Listen carefully. The equivalent capacity of a infinite network, see, so the equivalent capacity of infinite network is shown in the figure. Capacity of each capacitor is 1 microfarad. You have to find total capacitance across which point? AB. A and B. So let us draw the diagram.
One capacitor here. Rohan, you remember, right? This question you were asking me yesterday. Rohan, are you there in the class or not? Be careful, okay, students? Sometimes I will be taking your names.
Rohan, where are you? See, this is how I come to know. Achha, he's there. Very good.
So this is going up to infinity.
Some of you, I know you will on the video and go somewhere. Okay, be careful. I will take your names. And for other colleges also, I'm collecting the names. Oxford, Cordial, Carmel. Okay, I'll be taking your names. If you don't answer immediately, I'll call your parents and ask what happened.
Now look here. They've given you infinite capacitors. This is going up to infinity. Each one is 1 microfarad. 1 microfarad, 1 microfarad. We have to find total.
Now, to solve this problem, you have to know the meaning of the interesting thing about infinity. So I'll tell you a story. Listen carefully. Imagine I have a hotel with 10 rooms. And one of you come to my hotel and say, sir, I'm traveling today, so can I stay in one of the rooms? Then I will check. But I find that all the rooms are filled, are occupied. So I have to tell you, sorry, I cannot keep you in the hotel because all the 10 rooms are occupied. Understood? Nah? Okay. So you will go sad maybe, or you will try another hotel. Now think, I have made a hotel which has infinite rooms, and that rooms are all filled. How I made, don't ask me, that is not important. I have a hotel with infinite rooms, okay, and each room is filled with people. Now one of you will come and suppose ask me, sir, can I come to one of the rooms of your hotel? Since it is filled, I may say no to you, but since I have infinite rooms, what I can do? The person in room number 99, I will shift to room number 100. And 100, I will shift to 101, like that. That side I will keep doing. This side, the person in room number 2, I will shift in room number 3. The person in room number 1, I will shift to room number 2. Then my room number 1 will be empty. Then I will put you in room number 1. In other words, if you have a system with infinite rooms, if you add one more room or if you remove one more room, still you will have same number of rooms because it is infinity. So that is the very weird thing about infinity. TED Ed story. I don't know, Ma, what you are, Navin, TED Ed, what you are saying. So you will be having infinite room. This story I found from a book called 1, 2, 3... infinity. It was written by a person called George Gamow, which is a Russian scientist, okay, Russian physicist. So coming back to the story, if you have infinite something, adding something or removing something will not change the system. It will still be infinite. If you understood this, now look carefully here. So this has infinite capacitor, right? Now let me take two terminals here, C and D. Okay, C and D. Let me remove this part. Please concentrate, even if you are need students. It's a very interesting question. So if I remove this part, okay, if I take only this part, this system, can I say is same as this system?
Can I say yes or no? Just tell me that. After knowing my story.
Can I say this system is same as this system?
Yes, we can say.
Since we can say this system is same as this system, look here. If I say total capacitance here is C, which I have to find, then total capacitance here also will be C.
Okay, that is because
this system is same as this system.
Okay, in question, in exam, if they remove one of them and ask you this question, same answer only you have to tell, no,
because it is infinite. So between these two, if the capacitance is C, matlab this whole, all these capacitors, if they have total capacitance C, then here also it will be C.
Meaning, I can now, if you have drawn the diagram,
I can now replace all of them by one capacitor, and that is the total between C and D, which I wrote C already. So this is the total capacitance, this is the total capacitance, this is one, no? So this diagram is what you will get from the question. Okay, so if I want to repeat, look here, there was infinite network here, infinite. Total capacitance between these two has to be same as here because it is infinite.
Adding one part will not change the system, will not change the structure of the system. So how can capacitance change?
So if this is C here, total, if here total is C, what is the meaning of
equivalent capacitance? You can replace all the capacitor by one equivalent.
So you can replace all of them by one capacitance. And here, if you calculate, you should get same. Okay, students? So this is the main trick.
Once you know this trick, now it is very, very easy. Now you see. Let me change the pen.
So now you see. This I can further simplify. 1 microfarad. These two are in what? These two are in parallel.
So in parallel, how do you find total? You just add.
So C and 1 in parallel will give you C plus 1. And here one more, 1. And this is your terminal A. This is your terminal B. Total should be C only, remember. Now, these three are in what? These three are in what? These three are in... Everybody is busy writing, I think. So these three are in
series.
So these three are in series means total. Total is also C, remember.
That is the beauty of infinite.
So 1 by total is equal to here 1 by 1 plus 1 by C plus 1 plus 1 by 1.
Which formula I applied? Series formula.
1 by CS is equal to 1 by C1. Plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So 1 by C will be 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1 by C plus 1.
Okay. Right, fast.
So by adding one more unit, the total capacitance remains same because it is infinite.
So the story was quite important to understand this. So 1 by C will be equal to, here I can take LCM. So C plus 1 will be 2C plus 2 plus 1, 3. I hope everybody can do the LCM, right, students? So please do the LCM. C plus 1, 2C plus 2 plus 1 will be 2C plus 2. Cross multiply. C plus 1 will be 2C square plus 3C.
Correct, na? This can come in board exam also, board exam.
So then you bring 2C square here. Take this C that side. Plus 2C minus 1. So you got a what equation? Quadratic equation. What is the formula to solve quadratic equation? C equals to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So what is b here? 2. So minus 2. I did some mistake. Huh? This should have been 2c. Okay, so any mistake till here?
Naveen, any mistake till here? Correct only. Okay.
So b is 2 minus b plus minus root over b square. 2 square will be 4 minus 4. A is 2. C is minus 1 divided by 2 into a. A is 2.
I hope you know how to solve quadratic equation. Okay.
So you will get here minus 2 plus minus root over minus minus will be plus. 4 2s are 8, 8 plus 4, 12 divided by 4.
Right? Now, negative solution you cannot take. Please write till here. Negative solution is unacceptable because capacitance is a positive number.
Capacitance is a positive number. So, negative solution we will not take. So, positive solution, this solution only we will take. Only plus will be taken. So, C will be minus 2 plus root 12 by 4. So this will be root 12 will be how much? 2 root 3, right? It is 4 into 3. So 2 root 3 divided by 4. Then if I take in the numerator 2 common, I'll get root 3 minus 1 divided by 4. So C will be root 3 minus 1 divided by 2 microfarad.
Micro because all the capacitors were microfarad. Root 3 minus 1 divided by 2. Divided by 2, I think you have missed, Tanuj. Okay. So, quite an interesting question. Good question for 5 marks. For 5 marks, it is a good question. Okay.
Done, right? So Rohan, this is the way you should do.
Okay, let us see the next question now. Question number 2, very interesting, but it is simple. See what they are saying. It has come in CET exam also, CET. So you may be thinking, sir, CET question you are putting in JE. Because it is a standard question. Listen carefully. In the network shown in the figure,
there is C1 here. Sorry, C here, C1 here, C here, then again C here, C1 here, and C here. Then dot 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 is there. But luckily it is not going up to infinity. It is a finite. So here again C, C, C and here C1 and dot dot dot.
So dot 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 means what? There are many capacitors in the middle, same like this. So same thing they are repeating. Repeating, 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 repeating. I see.
Did I do any mistake? No. So you can see C, C, C1, C, C, C1, C, C, C1, C, C, this is C1. Oh no, this is C only.
Okay, so they are repeating the same circuit. Now, what are the values given? C1 is 6.
So this is 6, 6, 6 and C are 3. 3, 3, 3. Now look here. They want total here. Total capacities.
Now the problem is in the middle, we don't know how many are there. So how will we solve, sir, this problem? So you see the smart thing here.
This tree, you will come to know why this question came in CET, because it can be done very fast. C is 9 microfarad. Sorry. 9, 9, 9, 9. Okay. Now look here. You will come to know why this was asked in CET, because this can be done in 1 minute only. Look here. These three are in what?
Series.
So total will be how much? 1 by CS. 1 by 9 plus 1 by 9 plus 1 by 9. 3 by 9. Ulta will be what? 3. So these three capacitors are in series. Total capacitors is 3. So you can replace this by 3 microfarad, right? This 3 microfarad and this 6 are in what? This C1 is here. This C1 is here. Total of these 3 you will put here, na? Like this. Yes or no? 3 microfarad. This is 6. Correct, na? So this is total will be 3. That 3 and this 6 will give you 9. So here you will get 9. And then the same thing will be repeated. No, here 9. So here 9. Again, see, this 9 will be here. One more C number. So many are there. So this is how much? This is 3. 3 and 6 total will be 9. Then 9, 9, 9 will give you 3. And that 3, like that, you keep coming, will come with this 6, will be 9. 9, 9, 9 will give you 3. 3 and 6 will give you 9. 9, 9, 9 will give you 3. So total will be 3 microfarad.
Simple. Again, I will explain. Don't worry. But I hope, how many of you understood now only? How many of you understood now only? I will explain once more. Okay. Anybody else? Okay. Let me explain once more. Okay. Let me explain once more for everybody to understand.
See here. These capacitors are 999 in series. So series means total will be 1 by 9 plus 1 by 9 plus 1 by 9. So 3 by 9, ulta will be 3. That 3 and this 6, as I have shown here, are in parallel. So that will give you 9. Similarly, it will repeat now. 9, 9, 9 will give you 3. That 3 and this 6 will be 9 here. 9, 9, 9 will give you 3. That 3 and this 6 will be 9. 9, 9, 9 will give you 3. If there was here one more like this, then the answer will be 9. If this was also there. If this was again here, 6, 5. But this was not there. So 9, 9, 9 will give you 3.
Okay? So I hope everybody understood. No calculation here. Just logic.
Okay.
Done, right? I'll rub it now.
So today, how much ever we can do, we will do.
From tomorrow, we will start current electricity chapter. Very interesting chapter. I want all of you not to miss the class. Now, listen carefully for the next one.
Let us remember quickly. If you have two capacitors which are charged.
Okay, which are charged. Then what is the formula for force on one plate?
Each plate will feel an attractive force.
So force on one plate by other plate. How many times I will tell?
Force will be Q into
E due to one plate,
which is sigma by 2 epsilon naught, which is Q square by 2 epsilon naught A.
Why? Because sigma is charge by area.
So this part we have already done.
Try to remember it. Okay. Now come back to the question number 3. Again, this question can come in neat also, because very simple question. In the given figure, a capacitor of plate area A is charged up to Q. The mass of each plate is M2. The mass of each plate is M2. The lower plate is rigidly fixed. The value of M1 if the system remains in equilibrium.
So let us draw the system. There is a pulley like this. pulley is there, one block is sitting here, mass of this block is M1, the string runs like this, another pulley is there, this is the ceiling, and the string goes like this, and this string is connected to one of the plates of a capacitor, and another plate is rigidly fixed to the ground. Okay, this must be insulator or conductor, this must be insulator so that the charge will not go to ground. Now when you give this Q charge by induction, this will get minus Q, you already know. So this will form a capacitor, yes or no? This will be higher potential, this is connected to ground na, so zero potential. So these two will have potential difference, and whenever two plates form potential difference, they will form capacitor. So Q minus Q. Now they want the system to be in equilibrium. So equilibrium means net force should be zero. Okay, that is the meaning of equilibrium. So what are the forces this M1 is feeling? Mass of each plate is M2, remember that one. Each plate mass is M2, this also. Now come to this block. Why this is in equilibrium, ask yourself. Two forces are acting. One is mother's love. Mother's love matlab gravitational force, M1g. And here what force will act? Tension. So this body is in equilibrium. Why? Because tension will balance M1g. Let me write here. So for M1, for this block, tension will balance M1g. Equation 1. Okay. Now come to this plate, because there are two systems, one is capacitor and one is this block. Now listen carefully, this plate will feel how many forces? One force will be M2g. Let me draw it here. This is M2. What forces it will feel? One is gravitational force, M2g. It is connected to string, so there will be tension, and same string means same tension
as long as the string is massless.
So the tension here everywhere will be same, so T.
Another force will act. What is that another force?
These two are charged, they are capacitor,
yes or no?
So these two are charged oppositely, so there will be an electrostatic force. What was the formula for that just now? I wrote here Q square by 2 epsilon naught A. So for M2, which forces will balance which force? Upward force is tension. So tension should balance downward forces. What are the downward forces? M2g plus Q square by 2 epsilon naught A. Equation 2. Remember, they want this mass. This is the question. So what I will do? Tension is not there in the option. Since tension is not there, equate. So put this tension here.
Okay, students. So if you do that, let me slightly, yeah.
So if you put this tension here, what will you get? M1g equals to M2g plus Q square by 2 epsilon naught A. Then from here, you can bring this one this side and then find M2. Which option will you get? If I bring it this side, it will be M1 they want, no? So, just divide by G. Both, no need to bring anyone any side because they want M1. So just divide by G. So if you divide by G, this G will go, this G will go, and here one G will come. So option C, yes, correct.
So if you see carefully, this is just first PU only, first PU topic only. However, by putting a capacitor, I made it into a second PU topic. So it is a mixture of first PU and second PU. Right, first. And this is the new quantity for second PU, electrostatic force on one plate by other plate. Okay, see the next question. Oh, it is a wonderful question.
Best question.
Need people also concentrate. Okay, last question for today.
So let me clear the board first.
And don't leave the class, okay? I have some few announcements to make. So let us start.
Question number four, you see. The plates of a parallel plate capacitor are charged up to 100 volt. Now, after removing the battery, so let us draw a diagram first.
So you had a capacitor which was given some potential difference V, which is given 100 volt. And the now, after removing the battery, what they have done? They have inserted a 2 millimeter thick plate, which is a dielectric.
What will happen when you do that? When you do that, capacitance will increase.
Now you know that there is no battery, so charge cannot change. So charge will be same. And here, what was the charge initially? C into V.
Now, listen to the question. They are saying to maintain the same potential difference, the distance between the plates is increased by 1.6 millimeter. Then what is the dielectric constant of the plate, they are asking?
Suppose you don't do any change. You just put one dielectric here. That will increase the capacitance. You know that Q equal to CV, so V will be Q by C. Q remains the same because battery is removed. Correct, na? So Q will be same, but capacitance will increase, so potential difference will decrease.
But the question said, to maintain the same potential difference,
they have to increase the distance they are saying. By what increase? So if this is D, they have increased by 1.6 millimeter. Okay? So they want to maintain the potential difference same.
Now look here.
So to maintain the same potential difference, this has to be same, they are saying potential difference should be maintained same. You know charge has to be same. Why charge has to be same? Because battery is disconnected. Where will the charge go, ma? Where it will go?
There is no battery to go there or come from the battery. So charge will be same 100%. In the question they told, they want to maintain same potential difference.
So if this is same, this is same. C also has to be same.
Understanding?
So capacitance of this initial, if I write C1 and this C2, then that should be same.
That is the main thing. Once you do this, then you know the formula. Pata pata answer will come.
What is the capacitance of this? Epsilon naught A by B.
Correct, na?
Here, be careful. Dielectric is there. Epsilon naught A by thickness. This thickness divided by dielectric constant K plus remaining thickness. What is the remaining thickness? Remaining thickness is how much?
D minus T or D plus 1.6 minus T?
I hope you all remember, right? The formula D plus 1.4.
1.4 we will write later, Prakruti.
So right now the remaining distance is D, this total distance, D plus 1.6 minus thickness divided by 2. So it was important to move this plate. If you don't move this plate, then these two cannot be same.
But now you can make it same. You can see
epsilon naught A will cancel. So 1 by D. What was D given? D was not given. Thickness was given 2 millimeter divided by K. And this will be 2 millimeter this is not given. D, this is 2 millimeter. So it will be 2 minus 1.6 will be, sorry, 1.6 minus 2 will be minus 0.4 divided by 2. Prakriti, how you got 1.4? This is D plus 1.6. This is 2 millimeter. So from this, you have to subtract this. This is bigger, no? D is there. So this minus this will come D, this distance minus thickness will come D minus 0.4.
Oh, you thought 16, huh? Okay.
So then we can now easily solve. Bring, open this part. So 1 by D will be, oh, no. I have,
sorry.
This is in the denominator. Sorry, students. This is in the denominator. So first you write till here.
So I hope everybody understood.
They told the potential difference here and here should be same.
Potential difference same matlab
C also has to be same because charge is same in both the cases.
Right? Hemant, class will end at 11 o'clock. Okay.
So this C1 and this C2, capacitance of this and this should be same. What is the formula for capacitance? Epsilon naught A by D for this. And for this, you have to remember the formula which I told. The formula for this was, if you put a dielectric, then what was the formula? Epsilon naught A by T1 by K1 plus T2 by K2. Here two mediums are there. One is this, other one is air. This is also air. Correct now? So one thickness is T. Remaining thickness, how to find? This minus this. So D plus 1.6 minus 2. Now you cross multiply. Best thing is to cross multiply. So if you cross multiply, what will you get, students, here? Cross multiply like this. You will get T plus K. Oh, T was 2 millimeter, right? 2 millimeter. This was 2 millimeter. This is 2. So it will be 0 minus 0.4. Minus 0.4 cross multiply 2 by k plus d minus 0.4 by 2 will be equal to d. Right, students? 2 by k plus d minus 0.4 by this 2 came from where? This 2 was not there. This was just 1. Okay. Then you this d and d will cancel. Take it this side. So 2 by k will be 0.4. Right? Take it this side. D minus D will cancel, cross multiply, K will be 2 divided by 0.4, 20 by 4, that will be 5.
Okay, so the answer will come as 5. Dielectric of air you have taken 2, very good. Samyak, I did the mistake, so this is 1.
So this completes the problem. So first thickness is T, remaining thickness is D plus 1.6 minus T. And first medium dielectric constant we have to find. And second one is air. Air matlab 1.
Okay. So we'll stop for here. The remaining questions, I'll be posting the solution on Thursday. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Have a good time. Thank you. Please write down whatever is the announcement is. Please see the assignment. Okay. Yeah. Assignment. I think I already told about the assignment. So no problem.